Hey and welcome back to this devlog episode about my game named Catch Me, which is a fast-paced top-down game about making enemies collide to kill them. In the last week, I tried to polish my game a lot and also improve some small things. So let's get right into it. The first small improvement I made this week is about the dash ability of the character. The dash ability was the first ability I implemented in the game, and after some time I found it to be a bit boring and also weak compared to other abilities. For example, you have the slow-mo ability, which slows down time, so you have more time to react to enemies. Or you also have the missile launcher ability, which, who would have guessed it, shoots missiles and these missiles destroy nearly everything in their way. That's why I thought that it was time to upgrade and buff the dash a bit. So I allowed the player to dash straight through enemies to make the ability more useful. And with that I also increased the cooldown by about 1.5 seconds, so you know it won't be overpowered. Now I think the dash ability is a valuable option for the player again, and it competes with other movement abilities. But I would really like to see your opinion or ideas on that in the comments. The next few changes were more on the polish side of things and are not that impactful. So for example, I made the bar here on the top, which is used to display the progress of a level, fill up more smoothly and slowly. This is just a purely aesthetic choice. I also changed the explosions of the opponents to be more rewarding and less distracting than before. The old death effects were just too big and annoying. And the new explosion effects also apply to hits of every bullet and the death of the player. While I polished and improved some things, I also decided to throw away the old level selection screens. They just looked kind of messy and had no clear concept going for them. So I redesigned all level selection screens from the ground up. I just love the pattern of the squares with the slight gradient and the smooth animations. Looks very modern and minimalist. Maybe you also noticed that I added a color gradient in the background with the help of Black Farm Prod's tutorial on 2D lights. A very helpful video that I will link for you in the info card and down in the description. Maybe you also noticed that I changed the background colors and the colors of every enemy once again. I still wasn't completely happy with the colors, but now I think they look better than before. I think the level select screens now look way, way, way better than before, and the levels also feel a bit more harmonic and alive. So I would really appreciate it if you let me know your opinion on this new design. Another thing I paid attention to this week is the performance of the game. It is quite important that the game runs on nearly every computer without FPS problems. So I changed things like the resolution of images or the update rate of trail renderers. One thing that I would really like to add is the option to turn off post-processing in the options menu. But I actually have no idea on how to achieve this in a clean way, and I also didn't find any helpful info on the internet. So if you know how to disable post-processing stack v2 in Unity through the options menu, please let me know. I also decided to work on some sound effects for the game. I already had some, but I wasn't satisfied enough, so I redid all ability sound effects. For example, the shield ability, or the slow-mo ability. I'm quite happy with them, but I need some more and new sound effects for all explosions. And I will also have to make some music for the game before it's finished. The problem is that I have nearly no experience in making music, so if you have any tips for creating music, please let me know. I'm also open to any suggestions on which genre or theme would match for the game. So in the next few weeks, I will try to make and implement some music and some more sound effects. And that's it for this devlog episode. As you know, you can write your feedback in the comments down below. If you enjoyed the video, then please leave a like, it would help me a lot. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.